Welcome everybody to our YouTube channel, Learn Project Management. And today is going to be the lecture number 5 on the resources. We have given so far 4 lectures in English, plus around 6 lectures in Arabic, but we have playlist for English for who is interested in English. Okay. And we remind you that our channel will help and give full courses for beginner and expert in B6, PMP, risk analysis, and Six Sigma, and let's continue. And here is a YouTube channel, Learn Project Management, with our logo that match our Facebook page. Okay. And here's a playlist, so you'll find under English playlist all the English lectures. And if you would like to review any samples of PMP and risks and Six Sigma that we have added, you can go here for overview of the channel or PMP, and we have another one for Arabic. Again, if you don't download the software, you can go and download from edelivery.oracle.com, and we have a lectures how to download that with the links. I'm gonna add it again under the video, and we'll keep it under each video to help you guys download the software. And we'll have another lecture how to install it. End of the project or end of this course, we'll explain a complete project for highway or bridge or building. From A to Z, we'll go from scope identifications, review the drawing, contract details, creating the WBS, like the one in the screen right now, and creating activities and the resources and earned value. So it's gonna be a complete lectures, 1-2 hours, that summarize the full course. But the intention right now to make the course is very easy, 10-15 minutes for everyone, for easy to follow up. Today we're going to talk about important things in resources, cost account and cost units. What we're going to do, we're going to go to the live software guys to tell you how to do that. So here is the model of the project that we have added before, and I added my Google Drive under the videos to be able to download this complete project. And I will add the link of my Google Drive so that you can download the PDF, or if you would like to download the XCR file, the Primavera file, you can download. It's called City Center Office Building. And let's go for the resources. If you look for this nice guy on the left side, it's called resources. If you don't like that, and if you go to the display current project, I will go here, press by my mouse, collapse all. And you will get you the 3 categories of the resources that we have talked before about them, and you can open any one of that and you can check all the detail of the resource. Okay, let us go back by the way for the structures, and here we will go where guys, we'll go to the begin structures, and I will go to the resources. We can add any of these resources here. Let us add something like that. This one has resources already. Okay. So when you open this activity, you will find the third tab is called the resources, and they have here the cost account. I would like to go to, by the way, this labor construction. I will press here, and I would like to assign, by the way, HVAC. I can add the HVAC. Okay. So you can go to each one of these, and you just double click, and you assign the cost code you like. Okay, how we add the cost code? Let us go to the enterprise and then go to the cost account. Okay, and you will find here I filtered by the current project cost account, but I can add, I can copy this one, copy. Okay, and then paste, and I can move by this arrow here to make it the same level. I can call it, by the way, anything mechanical, MAC. And here I can call it mechanical, like that. And then I can add, by the way, the ID, so maybe M1, keep it mechanical. And you can add here any description you would like to add. Okay. You can modify here whatever you're building one or building two or anything that you would like to add. So to add cost account, go to enterprise cost account. You can copy from the existing or you can add here, and you can give the ID, name and description. Great. So now we learned how to add the cost account. We need how to assign for each activity the cost account. Okay. What is the next step is to add unit. I need for this carbon to have, by the way, 200 hours. I need for this iron here to have 300 hours. Okay, and I can continue adding all my units. You should have the project estimate or the quantities or the bill of quantities and with all these details. And to be ready when you go to the P6, you can just download this. You will find all this information with your costing account department or with the project manager or the project document. And it's gonna be easy in a spreadsheet to go for each activity here and to assign the units that you would like. Okay, so today is gonna be a simple course in identifying the resource, adding the cost account and adding the units to be ready for the next lectures. Create the baseline and doing the update and earn it value. I hope this simple course is easy for you guys. If you have any questions, let me know. But it's very easy. You have to go each activity and you assign the resources like what we did, and you go and assign the cost code. Okay, I'm gonna add, by the way, HVAC or whatever you would like to add, and I'm gonna add for the cement, by the way, 200 by the way ton. Okay, and also you can go and you can go here again to the resources and check, by the way, how much price of the cement. If you would like to change, if the price of the cement is changed, I can make it, by the way, $220 per ton. Okay, so that when you come to the activity here and you add it 200 ton, the program will calculate 200 ton multiply by the unit price, which is a ton, and give you the price of the cement, gravel, everything. So once you add all the resources here with the unit and you have the costing account, so that you can group all of that, you can group by the costing account system. So each company, they have costing account system. They would like to group, by the way, the building under costing account, the HVAC under building account, under cost account, and also the electrical work. They have costing account for electrical work. It helps when monitoring and controlling the project to know which cost account is above cost or under cost or something like that. So it is very easy and simple. And let us start next lectures with creating the baseline, doing the update, and go for any value. Interesting lectures gonna happen from next time, because all of these are simple, and we're gonna have a complete module by end of this easy course. If you like the lectures and interested to have more courses and engage with us, and if you have any questions, hit like and press the bell here and subscribe to our channels, because it's free to give hand to everybody and help as much as we can. And we'll send you all the information you need with template. And thanks so much for watching, and see you in the next time for creating baseline. Bye bye.